Hello friends, my name is Kishan Gupta and my topic is computer viruses and computer bombs. Let's get started. Firstly, the introduction of viruses. A computer virus is a program that reproduces its own code by attaching itself to other executable files in such a way that the virus's code is executed when the infected executable file is executed. Second is a bombs. The introduction of bombs is a computer bombs is a stand-alone malware subcomputer program that replicate itself in order to spread to other computers. Itself, a computer network separate itself, attacking on security failure of the targeted computer to access it. A typical life cycle of computer viruses. The viruses waits until user transmits the infected object to another computer. Second is a user transmitted an infected object to the another computer. And third is the viruses located and infected suitable object on the new computer. Types of viruses. First is the macro viruses. Second is the override viruses. Third is the direct action viruses. And fourth is the multi-parties viruses. Types of bombs. Email bombs, internet bombs, instant messaging bombs, and file sharing network bombs. What is the difference between computer viruses and computer bombs? First is definitions. Second, how does it infected a computer? Third is how can it spread? Fourth is does it infect files? And fourth is whose spread is more? Trojan horse. A Trojan horse is full of a much trickery as a mythological Trojan horse it is named after. Second is that a Trojan horse at the first glance will appear to be useful software but will actually do damage once installed or run on the computer. Third point is those on the receiving end of the Trojan horse are usually tricked into opening them because they appear to be receiving legitimate software on files from a legitimate source. Fourth is that Trojan horse are also known as to create a backdoor on your computer that gives malicious user access to your computer, possibly allowing confidentially or personal information to be compromised. Unlike viruses and bombs, Trojans do not reproduce by infecting other files, nor do they self-replicate. Trapdoors. Trapdoors are also referred to as a backdoor and byte of code embedded in program by the programmers to quick gain access at a later time, often during the testing or debugging phases. In an unscrupulous program, possibly leads to the code to simply forget to remove its potential security hole it to introduce. Hackers often plant a backdoor on previously compromised system to gain later access. Trapdoor can be almost impossible to remove in a reliable manner. And last is often reformatting the system is the only sure way. Super zapping. First is a useful software that bypass normal security constraint to allow unauthorized access to data. For example, such as a program may issue command direct to the disk driver without going through the normal file routines, bypass not only security restriction but also leaving on no audit trails. Logic bombs. Logic bombs are a small programmer or section of a program triggered by the some event such as a certain date or time, a certain percentage of disk space filled, the remove of a file as soon. For example, a programmer could establish a logic bomb to delete critical section of code if she is terminated from the company. And lastly, the logic bombs are most commonly installed by insider with access to the system. Thank you.